But there are people who are very selfless, irrespective of your generosity, your kindness. They can actually still be sensitive to say, I know you're my friend and I know you're very nice to me and I don't need to skip that line, especially if your relationship is involved. I cannot come in your apartment on Tuesday at any time because I know you need privacy.
Yeah, we need but those friends.
Yes,
hey, we
but
do
those
need...
selfish ones, someone would just knock on the door without even letting you that I'm coming.
Yeah. And they what start dishing up for themselves.
Of course, there is no sense of respect. Theo, relax.
Welcome then to One Shed. This is another sizzling and episode of the channel. We're going to be talking love, but now we're talking about people meddling in other people's things. Aban Batandi. Now, I'm joined by the two lovely people that I'm always joined by. Not even always, but for the past two episodes, if you go back and check them, they've been joining me. Lebron.
Hello.
And One Shed.
Hi, guys.
Anyway, like, subscribe, comment, because this channel is all about you and the content that we believe that you need. So do make sure that you talk to us as we talk to you about these things. These people that are joining me, they're not experts. No, they're not. They're just people to help me understand more about such things that I'm talking about on the show. So today, guys, we are talking about friends' interference in our affairs. How many occasions have you had your friends interfere in your affairs? Just think about it. Just say a number. Just say the number before we get to the questions. Just say the number.
Zero.
Well, none.
Zero.
Altogether.
Did you really say zero?
Yeah.
So your friends never interfered in every affair?
Nah, I don't have
many. Level?
No, I do not have friends as such. So it's just like gray.
So is it one and a half?
Like gray.
Zero and a half.
Zero, like negative zero.
Okay. I guess I'm the only one who's had like friends. Now let's to understand this, right? What role must our friends play in our relationship? What are your thoughts on that?
Look, more than anything, our friends are like our support structures.
Friends.
You know, they are just our support structures.
Mm-hmm.
Like when you need a friendly advice, career related, you know, that's type
friends.
Of thing. Outfits related.
The combos, yeah.
You know, if this one matches, but don't get them in your relationships or whatever. Like there's got to be boundaries.
All right.
They could really mess up things.
They could really do that. What about you? Mm-hmm. What do you think about that?
Well, I think, as she said in previous episode, she was emphatic and she reiterated this, that there is always two sides to every story. I believe that sometimes it's necessary for your friends to be there.
Mm-hmm.
You, especially when your partner is abusive, you need a shoulder to cry on, you know, to understand that this person is not worthy of my love. And people who can make you realize that sometimes are your friends. You know what I mean? So, I mean, like, some people are dying in relationships because they bottle up and they are cocooned in their relationship. A relationship are secrets and all of that.
Mm-hmm.
So friends come in where now you are abused and they are taking advantage of you. A friend is going to come in and say, you know what, my friend, I think you deserve more. Or go and tell your parents and say,
you know
what, that relationship, mama, you are
crying.
It's going to die in that relationship. It's toxic.
I'm crying. Now, let's go to the difference, the comparison. There's friends that build, and then there's friends that destroy.
Yeah.
Can we just go through the differences between friends that build and friends that destroy?
Mm-hmm.
You can also tag along and tell us your thoughts on that just below by commenting and sharing your thoughts. It could be an essay. It's fine. We'll read it. But what are your thoughts?
Well, like you, like the difference between those two people is that friends who actually
build
are the friends who are actually going to validate you in a lot of cases. Like it's validation, it's attention. Not only do we get attention in romantic relationship, but friends who actually give you attention, who are very attentive to say you've not been your normal self the past few days.
Yeah.
What's up? then you know you've got a good person going. But a friend who'd actually demote you also does that, can actually check up on you just to keep up for update purposes, you know, just to know exactly what's happening in your life. And in a lot of cases, friends who are too much of demoters would never validate you.
Haters in the building.
So in a lot of cases, they'd ask you what you're up to. You tell them, I just got a new job. When did you apply?
Why didn't you tell me we
could have applied together.
That is very true.
No Yes, also remember that we have that 3% jealousy inside of us. Natural.
The natural jealousy,
it's in us. We human, we're perfect.
Just a little.
But also, if you're my friend, I'm going to emphasize it. Rio, to me, I wish I could have applied this job with you. You are highlighted, but I am very much happy for you. So much. That is what we should like. Those are for keeps.
That is very good. What about you? What do you think about that?
Yeah, I thought maybe when you're asking the question, you were asking in the context of relationship, bad friends and good friends.
They go anywhere, bro.
Yeah, so I think
the fact is they're in your affairs.
I'm gonna tackle it in the context of relationship. Like, I believe there are friends who are fake and who are phony, who are pretentious. They behave like they want the best for you, but they do not necessarily want the best for you. They could tell you that, you know what, friend, if that partner of yours is not a good partner, knowing that they have ulterior motives. So those friends are the friends that we know are bad friends, but seldom you won't realize them. You wouldn't realize them. But there are friends who really mean it. When they say, friend, you know what, that partner is a good partner for you. That partner is a bad partner for you. They are friends who are good. And most of the time, those friends are the friends who are concerned about your future more than anything.
Very true.
So if someone genuinely loves you, you're going to see their behavior or their reaction, their attitude around your future. As he said, maybe say we talk about job. Job is something that's going to raise you. It's going to build you. It's going to build your future.
Very true.
When someone is not supportive, is jealous, and is envying you on your job, you know that they are not for keeps. You should be very careful.
They ain't for keeps.
Yeah,
you can tell us your thoughts as well. Now, let's go to the last one. This one is a concern of mine. We have selfish friends, and we have selfless friends. But in a context of relationship, do we really need these people, though? And what are your thoughts on the two differences? Who would you keep? Who would you kick out?
Yeah.
Selfish, selfless to the relationship that you have? Who?
Well, yeah. I mean, like, as he said, I would steal the line that there is always 3% of jealousy and selfishness. I guess we have that thing going on.
So the selfish is 3%?
Yeah, the selfish thing.
Okay, cool.
Yeah, 3%. So everyone
is the rest of the remainder, 97%.
So everyone is selfish to a certain extent.
True.
So, but then I wouldn't want to keep someone who's overly selfish because they're going to be toxic. Every now and then, whatever they do, the opinion they weigh in is about them. Everything revolves around them. If you go out with your friends and they're going to prioritize themselves instead of prioritizing you, whenever you receive something, they're going to come first instead of you coming like in the intermediate position.
Very true. I think that's what she said. She said, like, they call you and then they ask you, like, so you got a new job, why didn't you tell me about it? It's always, it's what about
why
me?
Did you not?
Now let's get into you. What are your thoughts on the selfish and the selfless friends to the relationship?
Well, I think the most important thing that we need to highlight right now, right here, it's the fact that however way you portray yourself out there is the very same treatment you're going to get in return. You understand?
Speaking the same language to the universe right now.
Some get away with it.
Of course, they actually do. But the emphasis is for someone to actually act selfish towards you, chances are you would have maybe skipped some boundaries to say, no, friend, you can do this. Whatever you want in my life, you are more than welcome. There's no sense of boundaries. All right. But there are people who are very selfless, irrespective of your generosity, your kindness.
they can actually still be sensitive to say, I know you're my friend and I know you're very nice to me and I don't need to skip that line, especially if your relationship is involved. I cannot come in your apartment or wherever you stay at any time because I know you need privacy.
But those selfish
ones, someone would just knock on the door without even alerting you that I'm coming.
Yeah. And they what start dishing up for themselves.
Of course. There is no sense of respect. Theo, relax. Relax. I'm not that friend. I'm just going to let you know that I am coming.
It's too much.
But guys, it is really too bad. Like, it can get to that. True. But it actually goes back to how you portray yourself.
Yeah.
Very
so
true.
So that you might get whatever sensation you are giving out.
No, thank you very much for your opinions, guys. And that is how we wrap this episode on One Shente. The name of the channel is One Shente. Subscribe, like, comment, and drop your love below there. We need to hear from you. What are your thoughts? Follow us individually. Lebo, where can they follow you?
Facebook, it's Lebogang Johane, and on Instagram, it's Lebo Mohale, and that's just about it.
Mr. One Shente, where?
On Facebook, I'm Harold Low. One Shente again. On Twitter, I'm One Shente. On TikTok, I'm One Shente. Instagram, I'm Low Harold. And on YouTube, I'm One Shente. That's why you're here, guys.
All right, that's why you're here. But no, you came for this, didn't you?
She's taking the limelight.
Follow me on my social media platforms. I'm Theo Chaka. Thank you very much for joining me. It's been a lovely, lovely, lovely shoot. I hope you are motivated and I hope that you start seeing life differently. But always, always, always remember that you must not count time, you must make time count.